services and adopt an animal. These animals, of course, are not available for adoption at this moment. We need to treat them. We need to make sure they're medically sound before they go up for adoption. The individual that was arrested by the Altamont Springs Police Department, of course, will be going through a criminal court case, but she has given us over most of the animals. She wanted to retain a couple of the animals, so we do not have ownership of those. I'm certain the state attorney will work that out through the court system for the other animals. Our hope is that she never has another animal in her life, but that's, of course, up to the court system. For us here, our mission is to make sure of the safety and welfare and emergency management of the public in general and animal services of the domestic animals and other animals here in Seminole County, and we do that daily. This broke our heart yesterday. It broke my heart yesterday. I know when I got home, I gave my my dogs and cats an extra hug because it was heartbreaking to see what was out there. Unfortunately, we did lose one dog yesterday on the way here. We also lost a dog at the scene. So those dogs were near death already. During the transport, it just was too much, and we lost two additional dogs. So there were also other dead dogs that were found on the site. Altamont Springs Police Department is investigating that, and we really would have to talk about specifics when it comes to that, because that's in a criminal investigation.
And Alan, this is not a situation where she was feeding the animals. She was specifically collecting them. The ones that we're seeing here, they're sweet.
Yeah, all the animals are very friendly. As you see, this dog's running up to me right now. So all of them are quite friendly. They were clearly not fed. They clearly received no medical care. It was raining last night when we were taking the dogs out, and they were drinking from the roadway. So no water at all, clearly no water for an extended period of time. They just, normally when we bring in dogs, a treat will entice them. They would sniff off, they would get rid of the treat, and they were going for the water. They just wanted to drink some water.
So when these guys do come back to health, there's no reason why they wouldn't make a great pet.
These are going to be incredible dogs, and they're all different types of dogs too. There's beagles and Frenchies and all kinds of other dogs, so lots of different types of animals, and all of them are very playful.
Was she running a rescue, or was she just boarding dogs?
So we have been told she was not an affiliated rescue with us, but we were told that she had received an LLC, a limited liability corporation, and was trying to act as a rescue, clearly not doing what a rescue should do. We had some complaints, which is what launched our investigation. Yesterday morning, we met with Altamont Springs Police Department and jointly went to the house, and that's when we found the conditions that we were seeing around the house.
Do you know where she was getting the dogs from?
I don't know where she was getting the dogs from, and I have no idea. And yeah.
When was she first on the county's radar?
So a couple months ago, we started to get some complaints. We went over there, and we did see some pretty deplorable conditions. She cleaned it up, and we do give a little time period whenever we see something like that. We give them a little time to clean up. She did clean it up. Unfortunately, it relapsed back into the state that was prior to, actually even probably a little worse.
So when the first time they're called out, are they given a notice?
Yeah, so
time, and then how many notices can you get?
Yeah, so in our code, you are given a notice. So we have a standards of care certificate you must hold if you exceed a certain amount of animals. And we will go and look at those animals to see. She at that point had not met the not met the criteria for standards of care. So we give them up to 30 days to remedy those situations. She had remedied in about 2 to 3 weeks. So everything was clean, everything was good. She was back to normal, and then now we're another month later, and it was even worse. One question here, and then
the dogs look like they have been emaciated for longer than a month.
Yeah, this is clearly pretty bad. So she was on her way back. I'm not going to say the dogs were healed. They weren't. This is going to take these dogs. It's going to take us a while to get it back to where they can really be adopted. So we're going to have these dogs for a while. Someone asked about, you know, can you adopt the dogs? And we will be able to adopt the dogs, but it's not going to be in the next 3-4 weeks because we're going to be treating these dogs for 3-4 weeks and even more to get them to where they need to be.
And again, Alan, go through the treatment that was required, because it's more than just feeding them and watering them. You said there's a lot of things going on.
So they were flea infested, of course, feces, there were roaches throughout the... One of the individuals that was an officer said they don't need to go to Halloween Horror Nights anymore because that's how bad it was inside.
Can you talk about, apparently this lady has been on the radar with complaints from Orange County Animal Services for years.
We did hear about that there was some issue. This morning we got with Orange County Animal Services and we're doing a joint investigation. We were unaware of that until actually quite early this morning. So we're doing a joint investigation, Orange County Animal Services and Seminole County Animal Services, to see where did these dogs come from, because they didn't come from us. So they clearly came from other places, but we don't know where they came from. They're friendly dogs, and then some of them are even microchipped. So we're trying to figure out how they got to her residence in Altamont Springs.
So the dogs are super friendly now, other than really wanting water last night. What was the environment like?
The environment, I'll say, as an animal lover, it was incredibly sad. There were moments where we love animals and animal services. That's one of the reasons in 2016 the county manager asked me to take over animal services. She knew my passion for animals, and it was heartbreaking. I had to take a moment. A lot of the law enforcement officers had to take a moment because a lot of those were pet owners. Our animal control officers had to take a moment. It was heartbreaking. I don't want to get too graphic, but the smell was horrific, the conditions, and to see them so loving and caring, dogs that, and cats, that it's heartbreaking.
Now, Alan, just looking at the two beautiful little girls that we've got right out here, tell me, how much longer did they have?
It's hard to say. Because there was no water, so that's probably why. I mean, we just didn't get to that one dog in time that was there, and then it's hard to say with each animal. It's a little bit different, but what I do know is that
months, weeks, days,
weeks to days. Yeah, for some of them, are a little bit better conditioned. So, what's important is they are here now. And we're going to take care of them, and we're going to feed them, and we got a medical team that's behind us here that has been taking care of them, giving them flea medication or testing for heartworms, testing for everything else that we can to make sure that they're okay.
Can you talk about, now that they're here, you guys are still dealing with another group of dogs that you have under court control as well. How many dogs from that one and how many from this one? And how does that affect the shelter here and what you guys are able to do?
I'm glad you asked that question. The reason really for us, we're not the investigative entity. The Altamont Springs Police Department is. So I can't really talk a whole lot about the investigation process, but what's important for us here is, of course, we're going to take care of these animals. As you mentioned, we have 39 animals already under an animal cruelty case. We have other animals here for other types of reasons, individuals with comas and hospitals and sickness and things like that, where they're an individual in a home that have no family around. That's a huge burden when we only have a certain amount of runs, and then these animals are here and being treated and taken care of, and then another 39 is in the guys in jail. That's a huge burden, and that's really the message today, is we really need help. We need help with the animals that are available already for adoption. If anyone's, again, considering it, that's the message. Please consider us, because we really, really need your help, because we've got to make space for these animals.
And that being said, are you going to be offering any deals?
Yeah, we are. In fact, today we'll be launching. We're still talking about exactly what the deal is, but we'll be launching that. That'll be all over social media. That'll be pushed out to you all as well. There'll be special pricing and everything else to entice people to come. But again, we just want people to come to look at the animals.
Unlike the first case, though, these, she gave them up, so you can adopt these ones out when they're ready?
Yeah, as soon as they're ready. And as I mentioned earlier, some of them are worse off than others, so some will be available for adoption a little faster than the other ones. So.
And the easiest way for folks to see these is to go to your website or get pictures?
Yeah, Seminole County Pets, and you can look at all the different types of animals that we have.
The animals that you recover from this home, are there any that possibly might not survive that you're caring for now?
We're going to do everything we can to make sure every single animal we received yesterday stays well, and I have a whole medical team that's going to ensure that. So. Can I say for sure? I mean, I don't know what the underlying conditions of each animal is. We have done an assessment on them. We think that we've got a good handle on everything, but we still have to get some of the tests back to make sure that they're okay.
And again, we're seeing dogs, but you're saying animals. Give me the
girl. Dogs, cats, birds. So we had 26 dogs, 13 cats so far. There's still cats in the house, and we have traps in there, so we're still collecting cats there because they're running all around. And then there was two birds that we collected as well. And you had a question.
No.
Okay, you had a question.
Yeah. Can the public volunteer to come out and help?
Thank you. That's a great idea. That's a great question. Yeah. So actually, ironically, Saturday we have a volunteer training. So if you can adopt an animal, but you'd like to come out and help us with exercising the animals and things like that, we need more volunteers than ever before to help us with getting them out here to play with them and things like that, because it's hard for our staff, especially with the number of animals, to get them out of their cages each day.